Yo everyone, what is going on? Welcome to another full day of eating. But before I get stuck into that, I am going to do a workout. It is currently 8 o'clock in the morning and I am going to train upper body. And since my last video, my gym has sadly closed its doors. So I am doing home workouts for the foreseeable future. But that being said, I do have an okay home setup, so it could be worse. So this is what we are working with. I have a couple of dumbbells and my gym loaned me some 5kg plates because they are very sound. They also loaned me this barbell over here. There's not really much weight in it. It's probably about 5kg, but it is still very handy. We have some more plates in this school bag. I have a couple of these resistance bands that I bought years ago from my protein. I have a resistance band with a handle on the end. Haven't really been using this. I have a lighter set of dumbbells here. I think they are 4.5 kg, so haven't really been using those either. And I also have an ab roller over here, which is an absolute killer. So yeah, it could be a lot worse, and I'm actually kind of enjoying the whole like going back to basics and the minimalistic approach of home training. And I'm actually really enjoying creating home training plans for my transformation program members as well, because it is like amazing what you can do with just a set of dumbbells. And if that is something you are interested in, make sure you head on over to my website, jclackfitness.com, and check it out. But yeah, let's crack on with this upper body session. Okay, meal number one is going in. So we have two slices of low calorie bread, we've got some egg whites, spinach, mushrooms, and of course that ketchup and mustard combo, which is my absolute favorite. So yeah, this is a meal that I had pretty much like every morning in the lead up to my bodybuilding show. And the main reason that I had it was because I love it. But another reason is because it is just so filling. So in this whole meal, there is only 366 calories and it is absolutely massive.
Mmm. So good.
And if you are giving this like meal a go, make sure you get the French's mustard. There's some dodgy mustards going around Ireland. I think there's like a Coleman's one or something. That is crap compared to this. And the French's one is actually way better for calories as well. So keep an eye out for that. I got it in Super Value. Okay, I am just about to get stuck into some work. But before I do, I want to talk about my calorie goal. So today I am aiming to consume 2,500 calories. But yeah, my actual calorie goal over the last few months has been 3,000 calories per day because I am bulking at the moment. But very recently, I dropped that down to 2,500 calories per day. And the reason that I did that is because over the last few weeks, basically since this whole coronavirus thing kicked off, my nutrition has just been so poor. And I'm sure a lot of people can relate. Like, it is just a stressful time. And, you know, tracking my calories and macros were not at the forefront of my mind. But I'd say some days I was sitting like 3,500 calories per day, 4,000 calories per day, and things like that. So it was just getting a little bit out of control. And I needed to pull it in a little bit. So yeah, for the next few weeks, I am going to be consuming 2,500 calories per day. And I'm not really doing that because, like, I want to lose fat, even though I think I will lose a little bit of fat on those calories, but it is mainly because when I set myself a lower calorie goal, it kind of sparks a little bit of discipline in me, and it just encourages me to remain 100% on track, and that is something that I feel I need right now. So yeah, that is why I'm doing that.
All right, so it is just after 2 o'clock and it is time for meal number two. So I am going to have a turkey burger sandwich, you could call it. And these are the ingredients that I'm gonna be using. So I'm gonna have one of these sandwich thins, only 97 calories per thin. I got these in Aldi, but pretty much all supermarkets do them. I have this 50% less fat cheese that I also got in Aldi, and the calories on this are actually extremely good. So only 71 calories per 30 grams, which is quite low for cheese. We also have some turkey burgers over here. I'm gonna have two of those. I prepare six in advance and just kind of have them over the course of the following days. We have a salad bowl that I got from Super Value. I'm going to have the remaining half of that. And of course, I'm gonna have some ketchup.
All right, so I have lightly toasted the sandwich thins. You probably wouldn't even notice. And I have also heated up, the turkey burgers in the microwave. And what I'm gonna do now is add my cheese to the top and put them in the oven just for a couple of minutes, just so the cheese melts on top. All right, taste test. I've always actually noticed as well that extra low fat cheese never melts as well as normal cheese does, but for the calories, I do still think that it's pretty good and it's really tasty as well. The turkey burgers are kind of spicy, so it's a good combo.
For any tea drinkers out there, this is the perfect tea color. If you like it really milky, you're just a weirdo.
But yeah, as a little post-lunch snack, I'm gonna have one row of these sweet chili rice crackers. You get them in little and they are so, so good. Per row, there is only 105 cals, which I think is pretty good. So this is one row here. Like, what do you get? 1, 2, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. You get 12 crackers. But yeah, the best thing about them is they literally have so much flavor. Like, each cracker is just bursting with sweet chili, so they just taste so good. And what I always do is like lick the flavor off first. I do this with Pringles and Doritos as well, and then you eat it.
Okay, so it is dinner time. So after much deliberation, I think I am going to have a prawn stir fry. So I have my prawns here. I got them in Super Value, and prawns are just one of those foods that are just kind of so high in protein and just have basically nothing else. So really low in carbs, really low in fat, and just a really efficient way to get your protein in whilst keeping your calories relatively low. I have some cauliflower rice here that I got in Aldi, only 103 calories per bag, or 102 calories per bag, I should say, and full of flavor, so this will definitely be a good addition to a stir fry. I have some broccoli and cauliflower that I got in Tesco, and I also have this soy sauce. So I am going to use the light soy sauce, and I just have a normal soy sauce to compare the calories. So per 100 ml of this, there is 54 calories, whereas in 100 mils of the normal soy sauce, there is 112 calories. So make sure to keep an eye out for the light version of soy sauce because you will save a few calories in the process.
Okay, let's give it a go. I'm not sure if this is a bit of a weird combination or not, but I've seen like loads of recipes with all these things before, especially soy sauce and prawns. I don't know. It's actually really nice. Like, the soy sauce isn't overwhelming or anything like that. It just adds a little bit of a taste, and there's loads of taste in the cauliflower rice as well, so. What a post-dinner treat this is. And I'm a big fan of that summer fruits berry mix. You get it in Aldi. And the thing I like about it the most is that it doesn't contain strawberries, because I'm not a big fan. So good. And when I do drop my calories, I always like to put a little more emphasis on my snacks, feeding like a mini meal as opposed to a snack. So for example, like this has similar calories to what a protein bar would have, but this is like a lot more satisfying than a protein bar, which you would finish within like 3 or 4 bites. Okay, so it is just before 9:30. Rach is calling me. I will call her back. And yeah, it has been a very long day of work. I will tell you that. I don't think I am finished just yet. But I am going to take a little break and go down and have my final main meal of the day, which is always my favourite. So let's do it. So I think this meal pretty much just speaks for itself. Like, I don't even think I need to hype it up or tell you how good it is, because it is just ridiculous. Unreal. And a lot of you probably know that I usually have marshmallows in this meal, so not a banana, it's marshmallows, peanut butter, and dark chocolate, but I was kind of feeling a banana this evening, and I think it paid off. Boom. To finish off my calories for the day, I'm going to have a bag of these pop-outs from Aldi, and Lidl actually have a version that I usually get. It's so sad that I know all this, but I'm going to tell you anyway. And they're called Popped, and they're basically the same thing. And I usually get the sour cream and onion flavor, but recently, as of late, they have just been so, so bad. Like, I think they changed their recipe or something, because they just lack so much flavor, and they taste like they're meant to be sour cream and onion, but they taste more like ready salted or something like that. Something really, really bland. So yeah, I swapped over to these recently because these are actually full of flavor. The only thing is, they're like so addictive, it's so hard to stop, and that's always why I kind of leave calories for the whole bag, because if I didn't, I would probably just have the whole bag anyway. And yeah, I am going to wrap the video up there, but before I do, I want to display my total calories and macros for the day on screen now. And as you can see, today I hit 220 grams of protein, which is quite high. Like, I probably do not need that much protein in terms of muscle growth. I could get away with a little bit less. But the main reason that I do enjoy a high protein diet is because protein is the most filling macronutrient, like in comparison to carbs and fats. So having a high protein diet does benefit me in that sense, because as I said earlier, my appetite is just so big. But yeah, thank you so much for watching. And if you enjoyed the video, please let me know by giving it a big thumbs up, comment below, and please subscribe as well. Each of those three things means like so, so much to me. So if you could do at least one of them, that would be great. And yeah, I hope you're all keeping well during this crazy time. Hope you're not cracking up indoors, and I will do my best to keep you entertained by bringing you as many YouTube videos as I possibly can. So thanks again for watching, and I will see you in the next one. On your waist, runway.